There's revival and it's spreading like a wildfire in my heart. Sunday morning, hallelujah, and it's lasting all week long. Can you hear it? Can you feel it? It's the real gospel song. Oh, once you choose it, you can't lose it. Oh, there ain't nothing gonna steal my joy.
I got an old church choir singing in my soul. Salvation and it's beautiful. I got a heart overflowing cause I've been restored. There ain't nothing gonna steal my joy. No, there ain't nothing gonna steal my joy.
When the valleys that I wander turn to mountains that I can't climb.
Oh, you are with me,
never near me.
Oh, there ain't nothing gonna steal my joy.
I got an old church choir singing in my soul. I got a sweet salvation and it's beautiful. I got a heart overflowing cause I've been restored. There ain't nothing gonna steal my joy. No, there ain't nothing gonna steal my joy.
Oh,
clap your hands and stomp your feet till you find that gospel beat, cause he's all you'll ever need. All you'll ever need. Clap your hands and stomp your feet till you find that gospel beat, cause he's all you'll ever need. All you'll ever need. I got an old church choir singing in my soul. Sweet salvation and it's beautiful.
I got an old church choir singing in my soul. I got a sweet salvation and it's beautiful. I got a heart overflowing cause I've been restored. There ain't nothing gonna steal my joy. No, there ain't nothing gonna steal my joy.
Gonna steal my joy.
My Good morning, children. How are y'all doing? I pray everybody's well, having a happy, nice vacation after school and enjoying your holiday. I hope everybody had a safe and wonderful Christmas. Oh, my cross, it's not, I can see that it's not out. There we go. Now I feel better. All right. So, did everybody enjoy their Christmas? Did everybody have fun and enjoyed your time with family and friends and enjoyed opening gifts, which I'm sure y'all said thank you to Jesus for providing all those gifts for y'all, for giving your parents the ability to be able to talk to Santa and tell them what it is that y'all wanted, and they helped Santa bring the stuff to y'all. And it's today's lesson is going to be sort of kind of like that, okay? So let's bow our little heads, and we're going to start with our prayer, and then I'll do communion, and then we'll go into our readings. And y'all are going to have fun today. And I want y'all to download the papers that I sent for y'all, because it's going to be fun. Y'all are going to have a fun time today. All right? So let's bow our heads, and we say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, and deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Amen. All right, so go get your bread or your cookies, your wafers or juice, whatever it is that you're going to use, so we can all partake in the Lord's Supper and have it all, the communion together as a family. That's what we are, a family. So go get your items, okay? I'll meet you right back here. All righty. So now we say, Dear Lord, thank you. Thank you, thank you for providing this time for us, Lord God, for giving us the opportunity to gather together again once more, Lord God. We are celebrating still the birth of your King, of your Son, Lord God. Thank you so much for allowing your Son to come down and be with us, to teach us, to guide us. Lord God, we love you. And we thank you. Thank you for these elements. Make them spiritual for us and make them whole. In your name we pray, amen. On the night that he was going to be betrayed, he took the bread, a piece of bread. He lifted it, he blessed it, and he said, Take these, all of you, and eat from it. This will be broken for you. This is my body. He then took the cup. He raised it to his Father and he blessed it. And he said, This is my blood, the new promise of the everlasting life. This blood will be shed for you all in the forgiveness of your sins. Every time that we eat of this bread and we drink of this cup, we do it in remembrance of him. Lord God, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. We accept this offering, Lord God, and we thank you. Please make us whole. Amen. So now we eat as a family. And we drink as a family. And we say, thank you, Jesus, for your sacrifice for us. We love you. We thank you. We honor you. In your most precious, precious holy name, amen. Amen. Beautiful, beautiful. I don't know if you have noticed, but we do have a new item. Can y'all see it? This right here was gifted to us, to the children's ministry, by Pastor Nereida. She got one for the big church, and she got one for us. Wasn't that very nice? If you ever get a chance, remember to thank her for it. Because it's just perfect. It's just perfect for our classroom. All right. So today we're going to be reading out of the book of Matthew, chapter 2, verses 1 through 12. Okay, and I'm going to go, this is a story that can be read out of our children's daily bread. See, this is the Bible as well, the children's Bible. So this is still our daily bread. This is ours, okay? And it's a lot easier for y'all to understand. All right, so we're going to read two different stories, okay? And after the lesson today, children, we are going to go, y'all are going to get an opportunity to see a video. So I hope that y'all are with me and that y'all are going to be able to enjoy today's readings, stories, and videos, and the worksheets that y'all are going to be able to answer. And if you need to pay attention so y'all can answer the questions on those worksheets. Okay? All right. In the name of the Lord, this is the word for today. The wise man look for the king. So see how exciting that is? Just by the name, y'all already know that it's going to be nice, right? Alrighty. And I hope that y'all watched the video of the songs that I sent. I haven't got it. I'm working on it. So hopefully y'all saw that there was a special in there for y'all. Alright? Alright. So this is the word of the Lord. Matthew chapter 2, verses 1 through 8. This is 1 through 8, okay? The wise men look for the king. Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea during the reign of King Herod. About that time, some wise men from eastern lands arrived in Jerusalem, asking, "Where is the newborn king of the Jews? We saw his star as it rose, and we have come to worship him." Now, in a country far, far away, some astronomers called wise men, who gazed at and studied the stars at night, saw a bright new star in the sky. They knew it was a sign that a new king had been born. These wise men wanted to find and honor this new king. So they loaded their camels with gear and gifts, planned their course according to the stars, and traveled until they reached Jerusalem. There they went to the royal court of Israel's King Herod to ask about where they could find the newborn king. Of course, this upset the king. The king of the Jews, he didn't know about another king, and he worried that this new king would try to take his place. He gathered all the priests and the teachers and the religious law together and asked what was written in their books about the birth of this king. They told him that a prophet had prophesied that a king would one day be born in Bethlehem. Herod told the wise men to look for the king in Bethlehem, then to come back and inform him so that he too could honor him and take him gifts. But in reality, Herod intended to kill the new king as soon as he could find him. The wise man promised to return and tell Herod what they knew. See, and there they go. All right, now we're going to keep going, and we're going to read gifts for Jesus. And this is out of Matthew 2, verses 9 through 12. And as the scripture says, after this interview, the wise men went their way, and the star they had seen in the east guided them to Bethlehem. It went ahead of them and stopped over the place where the child was. They entered the house and saw the child with his mother, Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasure chest and gave him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Unaware that King Herod wanted to kill the new king, the wise men mounted their camels and followed the same bright star they had first seen in the east to Bethlehem. The star stopped above a certain home. The wise men knew that this must be the place where the new king was. When they entered the house, they found Joseph, Mary, and baby Jesus. See him? The wise men bowed down and worshipped him. They also gave him gifts of gold, myrrh, a special kind of fragrant perfume, and frankincense. Just before the wise men returned home, God warned them in a dream that Herod wanted to kill the child. Using a different route to avoid King Herod, the wise men returned to their home. See, there's a wise man giving the gifts to Jesus. Now, remember we've talked about this before, how Jesus was given all the beautiful gifts. And remember, in those days, to have that kind of gifts was very rare. It didn't happen all the time. They couldn't just go to Walmart, remember? They were actually very honorable, very prestigious, very expensive, very beautiful gifts that they brought to the king of the Jews, that they knew that God had sent him to be there with them. Okay? So we know that the wise men were they read the stars, that they were like scientists. They would study the stars, and that's what guided them to them. So they call them the wise men because they knew the stars. They could tell about the stars. They could tell the weather, and they could tell everything like that, like the weathermen can now. And so when they saw the star, they knew to follow it. Just like us, we say that Jesus is the light of the world. So see, think about that. In our heart, in our mind, and in our eyes, we should always be following the light of the world. Just like the three wise men, they followed the light. And in the previous story, it was the shepherds. Remember, the shepherds were told by the angels that the king was born. So they went. They followed the light as well. So what does that tell you? Always, always keep in mind that Jesus is the light of the world. And he's going to always shine. And as long as that light is shining in us, we're always going to be guided. We're always going to be led in the right direction, in the clear. I mean, if there's light, if you go into a dark room, you can't see. But if the light is on, you can see, right? So think of it that way. Always have that light on in your heart so you can always see what's right and what's good and what's honorable. Jesus loves for us to do the right thing, because that's what he taught us. That's how he taught us to be just like him. So follow the light, just like the shepherds did and just like the wise men did. Don't be a King Herod and want to destroy the good that has come from Jesus. See, Herod wanted to destroy Jesus. And that didn't happen, thank God, right? Because it wasn't what God wanted. God wanted his son to show us the way, to show us the light, to turn that light on in us so that we could always follow him and not be like King Herod, and to be nice, to be good. And even in the first Christmas, it had unfair things. And that was the most unfair thing to happen to Jesus, was that King Herod wanted to kill him. But just like, if you might think, you know, it was unfair for Jesus to be born in a stable with hay and the animals around him. But how else would we have received our king if not just like that? Just like God wanted it. He wanted Jesus to be born, not in riches with money and material and things. He wanted Jesus to be born with love, peace, joy, happiness. All those animals around him, his mother and his father right there with him, his earthly mother and father right there with him, and all the angels. What a most beautiful. Now, that you can say was a very, very expensive birth, because we had the animals. Expensive as in the love, joy, everything was all right here. The love, joy, peace, everything right there. And then the wise man brought him what he needed to survive. God will provide. God provided those gifts. Just like now, God will provide us with the gifts that we need to survive. So we don't need to steal or to rob or to lie and to be unworthy of anything that we get. God will provide. God will provide. Just like the illness that we're in right now, God will provide the healing. God will provide the answers. God will provide for the answers to always be. It's just so beautiful. And I hope that y'all understand that the first Christmas might have been inside of a stable, but it was the most beautiful, beautiful place. Because why? Because our King was in it. Just like you and I, we are the most beautiful people because we are all children of Christ. Because why? Because Jesus is in us. Isn't that beautiful? Always remember, I am, you say that, I am a child of God. I am beautiful. No matter what anybody tells me, I know that He loves me, that He created me. So I am worthy of every love, every peace, every joy that God will provide, because like I tell you, He will provide. I could go on and on, children, but I know you all want to go see the video. And I want you to see the video, pay attention. And always remember, you have the light of the world living inside of you. So always, always be faithful. Always, always turn to God. Always ask God for everything that you want, anything that you want, because He will provide. He provided us with His Son, His only Son, and we have Him in our hearts. That is the most precious gift that we could have received, no matter how much. So that's why I was saying, just like Santa brought y'all's gifts, the Magi brought, or the three wise men brought Jesus the gifts of life. I love you. Enjoy the movie, the video, and please connect with me. And it was beautiful to see y'all. It was beautiful to see y'all. I'm sorry, last week my phone wasn't working, so I couldn't record for y'all. But I mentioned that I really enjoyed seeing you all, and I'm so happy that y'all came. Keep praying. Keep praying. And soon we will gather all together and eat from the table as a family here. And we will be happy. I love you. Take care of yourselves. And I'll see you next week. All right. Y'all be good. And remember, you can't be bad. You can't be bad because the light of the world is inside of you, shining out. All right, let's bow our little heads and we'll say a prayer. And then y'all can go watch your video, okay? And do your worksheets. Y'all should know all the answers now. Okay. Dear Lord, thank you. Thank you for bringing us together, Lord God. Thank you for the word that you gave us today, the most beautiful word of all. Lord God, we love you and we honor you, Lord God. Thank you. Thank you for giving us your Son, the most beautiful Son of all. Lord God, thank you for allowing the Holy Spirit to live within us, your Son Jesus to live in our hearts, to guide us, to teach us, to lead us, to shine the light in the path that you have already given us. Lord God, keep us on that path. Help us to stay on the path of righteousness. Lord God, bless our families, bless our pets, bless our homes. Lord God, bless our bishop, our pastors, our ministers, and our leaders, and our teachers, Lord God. Keep us safe, and in your Son's most beautiful, beautiful name, we pray. Amen. Amen. I love you, and we'll see you next week. Okay? Besitos.
Far away from the city of Jerusalem, there lived a mysterious tribe of people called the Magi. The Magi were filled with wisdom and understanding, and they were respected by kings and other important people. As three of these wise men were gazing out into the sky one starry night, an unusually bright light shone, brighter than any star they had ever seen. They were amazed at what they saw and were convinced it was a sign that a great king had been born. Quickly, they set out on a journey to find him. The same light that had caught the attention of the wise men also drew several shepherds out from the fields and into the quiet and lowly town of Bethlehem. The glory of God shone so brightly that they shook with fear. But an angel comforted them. "Don't be afraid. I bring good news for you and all people. The Messiah, your Savior, is born this very day." After a long journey, the wise men arrived in Jerusalem. As they rode through the city, they excitedly called out, "Where is the newborn King of the Jews?" They knew this king would be different than any other king before. This king was promised to bring peace and joy to all the nations of the world. Surely someone would know of his coming. "We have seen his star," the wise men declared, "and we are here to worship him." But no one knew where this child could be found. Herod, who called himself King of the Jews, was greatly troubled by the announcement of a new king, a king who might take his place. He met with the Jewish leaders and asked them where the Messiah was to be born. Then he arranged a secret meeting with the wise men and said to them, "Go and look for the Messiah in the town of Bethlehem. And when you find him, let me know so that I can also worship him." But secretly, Herod did not want to worship the new king. He only wanted the wise men to discover where Jesus was, so he could have him killed. As the wise men left Jerusalem and headed toward Bethlehem, they once again saw the glorious light in the night sky. This light had led them many long miles from home, and now it would lead them right to the place where Jesus was. As the wise men drew closer, they were filled with excitement and wonder. When they stepped into the house, the wise men saw a young child with his mother Mary, and they fell to the ground and worshipped him. They gave Jesus gifts fit for a king, including costly treasures of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. The scene was incredible. The greatest of kings, born in the most unlikely of places. Mary took in every detail and tucked them away in her heart. She wanted to remember these precious moments for the rest of her life. Later, the wise men and Joseph, Jesus' earthly father, were warned by God in a dream that Herod intended to kill the young Messiah. God led the wise men and the new family safely out of the city of Bethlehem and far away from the evil King Herod. Eventually, Jesus and his family returned to Nazareth. As Jesus grew, he revealed more and more about who he was. He healed the sick, raised the dead, opened the eyes of the blind, and most amazing of all, he gave his life on the cross to rescue the world from the curse of sin. The wise men's journey had led them to Jesus, the Son of God, the King of Kings, and the Lord of Lords.